Hello, I'm Andy, and today I want to cast or watch a game which someone posted on ESOG. So I assume blue is Mr. Bamboy, and red is Zompa Pomku or something like that. I'm honest, I'm really bad with names, and they're always changing their names, so that's probably what it is. So they're both. I think top 100 players, so this should be a good one. And yeah, so as matchup, we have British against English. Map is Great Plains, so this map has a lot of hunts and you have a lot of trading posts. And yes, and typically it also has a good amount of treasures, also pretty many pretty easy treasures, so those beavers which you can just take when you pass it. So, yeah, I think with this version of the patch, it's not as bad as it was before. So, before you had like, you could get like 8 of those treasures if you just ran around in circles and got those. And yeah, so let's see who's who. So, I'm actually not sure who's playing against who, but. Or who is who, to be honest, so I'm just going to call them British and Dutch. And it's also better because then I don't know who won. Because usually the guy who uploads is the one who won. So maybe that's true for this game, maybe not. But in this case, I don't even know who's who, so I'm not spoiled, basically. That's what I'm trying to say. And yeah, so if this is a good one, it goes to YouTube. And if not, it doesn't go to YouTube. And I'm just watching it myself. So for the build order, so the Dutch is saving up for one bank. Pretty standard if you ask me. British is going for, he's not going for TP, so sometimes he do this as British. He's just going for mana houses. Or he has 3 mana houses. He's also getting a trading post. Oh, not a trading post, an outpost, but he's trying to secure those hunts, which is a pretty good decision. Oh, and here the action already starts. So Dutch isn't playing as standard as it seems, so he went up with the logistician, which gives him 1 veteran halberdier, and he immediately goes to work. So the biggest difference between a halberdier and a pikeman is that his base damage is way higher and he has way better stats, obviously. So that means halberdiers are way less specialized in that sense than pikemen. So you can kill anything way faster. So pikemen do have, I think, 8 damage times 5. And so you end up with 40 damage, if I'm doing the math correctly. And with halberdiers you do have a bit more damage. But the base damage is higher, so you can kill villagers faster, and you could also engage musketeers or something. Yeah, so I completely missed all the build order, so yeah, so whatever. So we have a barracks in the middle. He's going for even more pikey boy or pointy boys, getting some raiding kills in. He's completely wasn't aware that that was a possibility, the British player that is, and he went for a calf start, which are completely useless against halberdiers. So hussars you absolutely do not want to make against halberdiers. So yeah, the start is going pretty decent for Dutch, but then again he still made some hussars to go raid. I probably shouldn't go on fast, so otherwise I miss all the raids. And so, that means he can do some pressure on Dutch for some idle time, force a reaction. But then again, his the Dutch player, Louis Francis Albert Mountbatten. So if someone knows who that is, you can let me know. Otherwise, I could just. We'll probably look it up on Wikipedia anyway, and maybe put it in the description. Yeah, so he has done a pretty good job on hurting the Huns around his CC. So he doesn't take too much damage from the raids. I mean, he lost one villager. That's not too bad, considering he also used his military to kill a stable. And that's very good. And I think he should switch. Oh, he's not switching. So one way to go with this is to just build a stable, get some hussar, and go for heavier hussar. So this is actually pretty decent, because with hussars you can snare the enemy, and once the halberdiers get into melee mode, they can clean up pretty good, so they're pretty strong. Yeah, also because it's used, so rarely most people underestimate those units. So as you can see here, if you're not microing correctly against them, they will just clean up even the counter units. This was not a good use of your longbows here. What he could also do is, he could also make some skirmishes, but and now he sees again the stable. I don't know if he just spotted it or if he was aware of it before. I think he just spotted it again, and he knows, okay, there will probably be no infantry around for a good amount of time. Because he killed a shipment, and he built a stable, and you can't train infantry in the stable. So, just making more pointy boys, and yeah. So, those next 5 he's using to secure against the raids. He's also getting 700 wood and 700 coin. So, does it look like HUB timing to me? I don't think it does, to be honest. He could use the 700 wood to get a trading post out. He could also use the wood to build a stable or a second barracks, or he gets out another bank. So this is probably what he does first. He also still doesn't have a market, so maybe he's going for a market. This could also, yeah, so he's going for a market and a bank, probably a military building. Yeah, he's also using his halberdiers to destroy houses. So often when you're playing against British, you do not want to destroy the houses, because they can rebuild the houses and they get another villager with a house. But in this case, he is only at 8 houses and he's forced to stay in his base, because the Dutch player is playing really aggressive. So by destroying the houses, he actually houses the British player, and they are also giving a good amount of experience. 81 XP is, I think, double the amount of generic houses. So yeah, so it's a decent decision in some situations. So most players hesitate to kill British houses, but in this case, it's, I think, the right decision. So we see another raid here. He kills that one villager who wants to hurt. What is he doing? Why is he going for like 50 hussars? I mean, okay, he's catching out skirmishers. He also has a pretty good timing, because he just hit H3, so I think, I mean, it's a decent timing. If it was a good timing, he would have attacked like 30 seconds earlier, so that way he wouldn't have to fear a H3 shipment hitting. Because now I think the Huns are kind of useless. For the moment, because he's getting writers, and with writers you can chase them down. Oh, this is also probably a fight you never want to take, I think. So halberdiers against Husk, even if you have so many more numbers, Heavy Deers are just so strong units that it's rarely a good fight to take. Like they have melee resistance, they have almost as, or they have a bit less HP, but they have way more attack, they have like double the attack than Hussar in a straight up fight. So it's usually not a good decision. Now the writer join in. And his Hussar can't really deal with it. He's calling the militia to deflect it. Then again, writers are usually not the scariest of units. So, does he? Oh, he has the great coats already. So, you can't really kill villagers with writers. And he's also kind of wasting them, if you ask me. Because he still knows that there are a good amount of Hussar on the map. And he could really use, or he could use like 5 to 8 writers to chase him down. Now he kind of wasted them all. Yeah, I mean he kills the barracks for his efforts. Goes for the TC, so that's really ballsy if you ask me. C and the outpost is there, so actually pretty ballsy, yeah, it's the right word, I think. Then again, like, even I know that they are pretty good units, the pikemen or the Havidius. And I'm saying it, like, since a few minutes. But even I apparently underestimate them, because they build a TC pretty fast. Still some raids going on, so that's what I mean. If he had some more writers, he could just destroy the Hussars here and not lose a good amount of his villagers. Also, I mean, Havidius are really strong, but I think he would have needed 5 more of them to actually kill these TC, so maybe like those, instead of making those skirmishers, making more Havidius, he maybe could have pushed it. But yeah, so he's also kind of tired of those Hussars killing his villagers who try to hurt him here, and he wants to build a town center to defend those villagers. Probably here is a bit better to build it, so you could cover a bit more ground, but it, yeah, it doesn't matter. It shouldn't matter too much. Anyway, so also it's not going to get up with the Hussars still being here. So those Hussars did some really great damage. He's sending more villagers here. Can 5 villagers kill 2 Hussars? Probably, right? I don't know. Doesn't look too good, but he's also busy microing here. So now writers are coming and they are probably going to be dealt with. But those 2 Hus kill at least 4 villagers, probably like 5 to 6 or something. So they were pretty good. Also, here are some more. This is also a pretty good fight. You might be wondering why is the Dutch player taking such bad fights. Because he's fighting on 3 fronts, and so if you're busy microing, oh yeah, the skirmish is dancing with the bison, and if you're busy on 3 fronts, you tend to make mistakes, and that's what we are seeing. That's what we are seeing here right now. But now the writers are finally dealing with those Hus, and he can probably sleep well again, the Dutch player, the Louis Francis Albert Mountbatten. Ridiculous name. Probably a Royce or something, I don't know. I hope he's not crucifying me for not knowing that name. Oh no, the 2 Falcon achievement arrived. Oh, and first shot, it seems like he dodged it, so For those of you wondering how you can dodge a shot, I think the way it works out is if he shoots and in that moment you, or when he already shot, you have to click your unit somewhere and basically change direction, and then you're dodging like 80% of the damage of the shot. It works out yeah, like 90% of the time. And it's still pretty difficult if you ask me, so there are some players who can do that pretty consistently, but most players don't, so... Yeah, so now he's taking another good fight, or another fight, so this is a pretty good fight if you ask me. So he ran his hussars in, killed the falconets, so I think like 5 to 10... What? It could also be only 5 hussars going in for two falconets is in itself a decent trade. I mean, he lost all his riders in the process, but he's also killing a good amount of his infantry. And if you're wondering why he's going back, he probably thinks that blue has some hussars. Hussars popping out soon, and if they're like 5 hussars on those amount of skirmishers, they're just dead, and that's something he wants to avoid. So yeah, it even a 5 hussar shipment, so that's what I thought. So I thought he would go back, but he's also kind of... It's very ballsy what he's doing here, so yeah, I think he's overstaying his welcome here, and he's probably losing them all. And 5 writers, are they really enough, 5 writers? I guess we find out now. So now he's getting the snare of on those skirmishers. And still 6 hussars. He's also using his longbows to kill the rider, so yeah, so he's losing all his skirmishers. He overstayed his welcome. I was wondering why he was sticking around here, and now he got punished for it. Also, did he build a second stable, or was it a shipment? I think he sent a shipment, and now finally has the numbers to secure or to protect his skirmishers, but then again, skirmishers all died already, so yeah, so small little mistake. And yeah, now let's quickly take a look at the economy. The British is at 61 villagers, so he house boomed all his houses. He also has a second TC up here, which is used for map control to secure this gold mine here, and also for villager production, obviously. And so his economy is in a pretty decent shape, in a pretty good shape, I would say, because he also didn't get raided too much compared to the Dutch player, who's at 26 villagers. It's, yeah, it's pretty low if you ask me, so he got raided pretty hard all the time. I mean, he's on 2 TCs, and he also... Oh, now he's getting the Greatcoat upgrade, so it's probably a bit late for that. But better late than never. And he also only has 4 banks, as far as I can count. So his economy is in a worse shape than it should be. But then again, Censored Somali, He also overstays his welcome against on the other side of the map, and he's taking a pretty bad fight because Hus popped out, and so the Dutch player returned a favor on blue player. Blue player did the same mistake as the Dutch player. So yeah, so they're kind of even again, if you ask me. So let me just quickly check. So 63 villagers against 29. He has 4 banks, 4 banks is like 3 to 4 villagers each, so he's around 45 villagers. So British is in a, economically speaking, is in a better position. He also has some pretty good map control here. If he gets up this TC, he can secure so many hunts, so like he has like half the map secured here. And would have hunts for days. I feel me stronger now. Yeah, but yeah. But then again, Dutch is not out of the game. To speak, I think his army is a bit bigger at the moment than the British player. Maybe he's overbooming the British player, that is. For some reason he has too much wood, so I don't know why he's getting so much wood, to be honest. So yeah, maybe because he hasn't secured the hunts. I mean, if he would have gotten up this TC here, he would be in a great position in this game. But because he couldn't get it up, he also can't use his villagers to hunt, and so his economy is pretty bad, or it's not working. It's not as good as it should be, and he's forced to take this fight for his hunts here. I don't know if he saw those hunts, otherwise I think he would have gone to those hunts. So yeah, I mean, the economy in theory for British is better, but then he doesn't have the map control to use his economy to his full advantage. He's also getting the Cheyenne now, so he can use all this extra wood he has in the bank, if he's not forgetting it. Or he's using the Cheyenne for the upgrade where you can get some bisons. Or he just forgot about it. That always happens to me. Like I have this very good idea, and then I'm so busy keeping everything of me alive that I just forget about this great idea I had. Oh, he already used the bisons. Where did it pop, to be honest? Okay, interesting. Apparently he has this for quite some time. So, but to be honest, like if you build this trading post and you have so much wood, it's probably a decent decision to make those Cheyenne riders. They are actually pretty strong. And yeah, obviously if you have so much wood, you can afford them. So it's better to make them instead of Hussars, for example, which he really can't afford at the moment. So yeah, he's forced to stay on a mill here, forced to build a mill. At this point, he could also get a trading post. He's building a artillery foundry here, okay. Maybe he wants to petard banks. You need two petards to kill a bank, so it's probably always a good decision to petard banks if you have the can afford it. He's using 4 petards to see what to kill the TC. Okay, so he wanted to kill the TC apparently. Oh no, you need 3 petards to kill. Dang. I thought they had 2000 siege damage at one point. Did it get nerfed? I'm sorry, I never used those units. So I haven't done my math for it. So even though with 3 petards, it's still worth it to kill banks, because you're spending like 300 wood and 150 food, and you're killing 350 food and 350 wood. So it's a good trade overall. Also does more damage than killing a TC, if you ask me. The Dutch is already at max population. Oh, I'm watching it. Watching the wrong player. So he's. So yeah, so He's not fully yet, or he's not yet on the full population. But then again, the villagers or the banks are more important because at this point the natural resources run out, so your villagers tend to be less efficient than banks, at least in the transition phase. Yeah, so now. Now he's using the peach huts to kill the banks. It's, as I said, a very good decision. Something I would probably never think of, but smart on the censored Somali guy. For whatever reason, so I don't understand his name, to be honest. So why would you call yourself censored Somali? Especially considering that he's probably not Somali. What is the thought process behind his name? I'm just confused here. So he's now finding villagers again. And he could have went to the coin mine here way earlier to get even more coin. As the action was going around on this side of the map. But yeah, I think it's over for blue, to be honest. He's on 3 mils. He did the mill transition already. But he lost too many villagers. Like, the Dutch player caught up. He's still sitting on natural resources. His army is bigger. Yeah, it is bigger. I mean, he has a chance if he's microing his or if he's getting a good fight with his falconets. But then again, I think red has too much cavalry for them to be very effective. Also something, personally, I'm not a huge fan of longbows. I mean, technically they are a good unit, but they just don't feel good to use, if you ask me, or I don't. They don't feel good to use for me, that's what I'm trying to say. They have this attack delay, and they die so fast in melee mode, and you have to camp, and I don't know, I prefer to use skirmishers. Send us here again, those petards. I mean, he lost 15 petards and only killed one bank. So imagine 15 petards could be like 15 petards could be like 20 pikemen or something. And imagine if he would have 20 pikemen here, then maybe he wins this fight. But even then, like, Red's economy is just way better. And so he wins the game. So let me think. What was actually the game winning move for Red? Because I think Blue was in a better position at some point, or at like 10 to 15 minutes. But I think he couldn't secure the Hunts in time. So if he went for an outpost here and got it up instead of a TC, then he could probably hunt here. Or if he just used those villagers here, or those Hunts. Also something very smart of him to get those JN bisons so early. This is as British, especially, it's pretty good because you run out of here, or you run through your natural resources so fast as British, so it's a very good decision. So yeah, I think he maybe also the TC would have been a bit better here, not directly near the coin mine, maybe a wall here. So if this TC would be here, then here a wall and here a wall, he could have gotten those hunts, maybe hurt those hunts a bit here. And yeah, so the map control basically lost him the game, I think. So that's what I'm trying to say. Let's look at the post game. Dutch has a bit more resources. It's probably in the end. What had happened in the end? I think British overall traded pretty decent. What things considered. Let's see here. So here at this point. Here is, I think, where the Dutch player went in the middle of the map and denied half of Blue's villagers. This was probably game-winning move here. Villager population, villager count. That's why I'm here, like, it's so many villagers with his raids. Like, 14 villagers he killed. That's actually insane. So here he was in a really, really solid position. Let me see, let me see, let me see. Isle villagers I want to see. Yeah, so. Here he had so many villagers, so also so many idols all the time. I think it's kind of expected with Britain, but it's also, he also has a, it's just way too high if you ask me, or it's probably what cost him the game, that's what I'm trying to say. And he's also, he gathered way too much, or he had to gather wood because he didn't have the map control for more food anymore. That's what you also see here, so he's not really getting more food. And yeah, so I think map control won Louis Francis Albert Mountbatten the game. I think it was a pretty interesting one to watch. Of course, I kind of missed the start, the logistician start where you can get halberdiers. But other than that, I think it was a pretty good game, fun to watch. I hope you also enjoyed this. And yeah, have a good one. Bye bye. Thanks for watching.